I've been here all day. How long have I been? Nat, you've been here with me all day. How long
have
I been here? 11
a.m. and now it's 8 p.m.
It's been a day for me.
9 hours.
And Nat, you've been here all day too, so shout out to you.
I've been here for a long time.
You've also been here for most of that.
I've been here longer than you have.
He was here when I got here this morning.
To be fair, he's the new Harrington. He lives outside.
He lives here. He. I said, what are you eating for breakfast? And he said, this sandwich that I found at the Family Dollar.
Oh, that's better than him saying that, Ma, which is what I assumed he would have said.
Okay, there's nothing wrong with collecting groceries from the Family Dollar.
Yeah.
If you need Larry the Cable Guy mac and cheese from 2011, it's a great place.
If you need 70 grams of oregano for
and I will say
14 grams of protein in every sandwich.
What's the dollar store
and
that sound like?
It's made of rats.
What's the dollar store that's on like 34th?
What's your problem with rats?
Oh, the big one?
The big one.
I don't know the name of it, but I know the place you're talking
There's
about.
A dollar store where I receive the greatest deal in the history of groceries. You know this. The brie.
Oh, yeah.
So I found a wheel of brie in the fridge section, and it was marked $5. Mm-hmm. It was like a steering wheel size thing of brie. And I go, what the fuck's wrong with this? And I buy it. I take it home. I open it. And all the stickers fall out of it that say $5. And it was pre-cut into little triangles. I bought $150
holy shit.
Of brie for $5.
There was a viral Instagram reel where somebody slapped the, instead of $10 a pound, $10 onto a fucking half a wheel of Parmigiano Reggiano.
I saw that.
Dude, I was like, that's a come up. And his wife's like, why would you buy all that? He's like, give it to people for free.
We had brie every, dude, I came up with brie nachos.
I would fuck with that.
Which was brie on.
We gotta
like,
use duck coffee.
Yeah.
It was brie on.
I don't have that.
Whole wheat chips. We had brie on baguettes for every appetizer.
That's hot.
We murdered that brie.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Can I say to start the show, it's a very weird experience to be sitting at the table facing you guys. It's weird. I'm always back there.
Yeah. Same here. I'm always just promoting your asses.
What do you mean? I did the show with you last week.
He did.
Oh, this
Thank
is
Thank you
true.
For filling in for me.
Actually, you're in review.
We had to bring three dudes in here.
Yeah. That's well, what's such a
We had to bring a gangbang in here for Mike.
Nat, I will counter that alpha with, energy. It's been a pleasure watching you become a very good broadcaster. Yeah.
Thank you, everyone.
Mike,
yeah,
you're here too.
That.
Yeah, yeah. Natalie is really steering the ship on this program.
I hope so. Yeah. Or else they're going to hit something.
That's true. You are an iceberg.
He does a lot of behind-the-scenes work that I will address. Just now, I was scrambling to, like, come up with something to write here. And he was like, you see all the work I do every week?
Do you know how much harder it is for him to write than it is for you?
Yeah.
That's why it takes him so long.
Yeah.
He puts a lot of time and effort into it. Anyway, start us off.
We wanted to start off with a year in review, and you guys have a lot of podcasts
I meant,
on this network, especially. What?
Hi, everyone. Welcome to our show.
Oh, hey, everyone.
This is GaS Digital
this
Now.
This is GaS Digital Now, the GaS Digital wrap-up show. This is 9 to 5 Irish Natalie.
Just stack all the names.
This is GaS Digital Cow.
Hello.
This is soft gay blind Mike.
Yeah, and that's just Chris.
Thank
you. You lost Brooklyn.
That's fine. I lost Brooklyn a decade and a half ago when Zac got a rent-controlled apartment.
I think
anyway.
Brooklyn lost itself, to be honest.
Yeah.
You lost your Italian card, by the way. Have we addressed this?
No, I haven't. You haven't.
Oh, why? Did you start liking black people?
I'm Irish now, apparently, and I've always been Irish, and I've always also been Italian.
Oh, you did a 23andMe?
No, I just went to Ireland.
Oh.
I went to Ireland and he went, you're not Italian anymore. And I went, I don't
Can't
think that's
be.
How that
the
works.
23andMe is all of Anthony Cumia's relationships.
It's 23 1-year-olds.
Nice.
23 year-olds.
Hell yeah. So guys, you have podcasts on this
23's in me is my dating history.
We wanted to review the year here at GaS Digital. Now, a couple of days ago, Ralph and Lewis did kind of like a state of GaS Digital on GaS Me Anything. And I want to hear yours because you guys also have a pretty big stake in the company.
Wait, what did Ralph and Lewis say?
That's
you
a
know,
question.
They just like.
Did they say a bunch of jargon and then say, let's put a pin in this and then they'll do it again next year?
They took all your ideas, Chris.
Yeah. I mean, they regularly take all of me and Zach's ideas.
It's true.
Yeah.
They announced a couple of podcasts. They talked about the new website and the app. Apparently, we're going to be on Roku. It's a whole thing.
What are the new podcasts?
You know, not all of them are announced yet.
Okay, what are the ones that
the roast
on the
one, for sure.
Yes.
Spit
this,
roast.
And the Slick and the Thick were the two ones that were officially announced.
Okay.
So, I have another question for you guys. You've been here a year. I started working here in February. Natalie, when did you start working here?
May 2021.
You guys have seen us work here. What if you could give us a grade for 2022, what would you give us for our performances?
On a curve?
No. Grade me as a blanket.
Natalie doing a fantastic job.
Thank you.
Every time she fills in on anything I'm on. Mike, whenever you get drunk and are mean to Dylan, it's my favorite part of the week.
I agree. It's an underrated aspect of working here.
Yeah, I can't give you a grade on that technically, but I think you have better instincts for cutting clips than most of the producers here.
Yeah, you just gotta upload them right side up.
Yeah.
That was funny. When my first few months here, I think I didn't actually start uploading horizontally until June.
And everyone, oh, we have a blind guy doing the clips. What were we thinking? And then you really pulled through, and I'm impressed.
Thank you.
Well,
you got the job because you did a great job on Dave Temple's Unpopular Opinions, right?
No, it was because I made an Instagram account where I would just post gas digital clips.
All right.
He did it so long that they
started
paying him.
I made a fan page, and they started paying me.
Yeah.
This was like a Make-A-Wish.
You're not
Mike,
wrong.
You're a terrible bartender, a great guy, and you have so much ambition, and I think you're actually doing a great job. I don't want you to get a big head.
No.
I'm giving you a B. All right. Because there's always room for improvement.
And also, if you had a big head,
cocky.
Tip over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. You're great. I'm just saying you're not perfect.
Keep
I'm
you
giving
grounded.
You a B.
Yeah.
And Natalie.
A minus.
Oh.
Because I feel like me and Nat immediately connected.
I agree.
We got each
both
other's
gay.
Thing. Yeah, both of you. Got each other's thing, have each other's backs.
Totally.
And I do feel a little bit like she has slightly shifted the direction of the Real Ass podcast into now we have a few more opinions. And my opinions are not necessarily shoot away.
Rolled over.
Because I have Nat kind of, because listen.
I agree.
Shannon has fucking Stockholm syndrome. Shannon's just gonna shut
weird
down.
Way to say B from Staten Island.
Yeah. Shannon's just gonna Shannon's just gonna go into robot mode. I feel like Nat still has some humanity left in her, and I get away with more of my liberal bullshit.
Yes.
Because I have Nat on my side, and when I feel outnumbered, I go Nat in the booth. And I feel that across the board on all the shows.
Yeah.
And we might not necessarily agree because I say some crazy shit.
But I agree that having that backup is nice.
Yeah, and I like having that around because it makes me feel a little more sane.
Yeah. I have a couple things.
Let's hear it.
One of the things, I feel like it's different because you guys are comedians. But I was going to, and then Mike's is, so this is really a dumb question, I guess. Mike's is obvious. I was going to ask, what was your take one for the team moment this year, a.k.a. commit to the bit moment of the year?
I mean...
Yours is obvious.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, was it this year or last year, the SDR thing?
Which SDR
thing? I think that was last year, so never mind.
What was it?
The butthole contest. That was last
year.
Oh,
that was last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, then that. Okay, Chris, yours.
I mean, just in general, I don't want to do the naked roast. Zach's just my best friend.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't want to do that.
But how fun is it?
Oh, I have a great time.
It's
also
the best.
Karen Feehan looks great naked.
It's very nice.
Also
sure, Jason Ellis.
Also a bunch of people talking about how big my cock is for 2 weeks after that every year has been pretty.
You are pretty careful to stand close to me.
Yeah, that's true. Comparatively.
Yeah. Jason Ellis hammer.
Well, that's also the gravity that pulls me close.
Yeah. You're orbiting me. Yeah. I feel like I don't even have an answer to that because that's all I do.
Yeah.
That's just, I'm constantly going with the bit, right?
Yeah.
I feel like I very rarely get boo-boo face.
Is there a moment that you were like, I don't feel like doing this, but I'm going to do it?
Cause every morning.
Every day.
Yeah, when my fucking alarm goes off at 9:42, because I figured out if I get out the door by 10:15, I'll make it here before Lewis.
Right.
I do sometimes think about, like, there was an Opie and Anthony episode when, like, Dice was coming in, and Anthony just goes, I just woke up alone in my house, and I'm taking a piss, and I go, fuck Dice. And I just picture you doing that every day. You come
every day, my alarm goes off at 9:42, and I go, Fuck. It's just, and I love what I do for a living, but it's so Groundhog's Day at this point. Good morning. We have a great show today. Guys, we had a great show today. Guys, you know how great today's show is going to be? It's going to be a great show. We're brought to you by heroin sludge and ball trimmers.
Jesus Christ. It's almost like I've been feeding Zach truth serum for 12 hours.
I had the thought today where I could very easily do your intro for Bye Guys or any show where it's like, if you love the show, and I know you do, check out, go to gasdigitalnetwork.com and put in code X, Y, or Z in, of any of the shows.
I do that because I feel like it's fun for people.
It is.
Like, it's like sing-songy. It is. You know, there's days, it's...
It is High Society Radio. We're here. It's Thursday. I'm going to say a bunch of weird, crazy, wacky things, and now like I'm going to sound like I'm doing radio, and then all of a sudden, Johnny is going to tell me something about the hood.
Yeah, and I had a tough run for a month or two while I was writing on those roasts, yeah. And I was also here, where like I was kind of on call for crazy hours. Yeah. So I would be in a group chat at like 4 a.m. where people were like figuring shit out. Like, I fell off my bed answering a text onto my head. Like, I was like that tired.
Yeah.
And people caught me falling asleep on the podcast. Wow. There is footage of me. I don't want.
Well, nobody knew. To be fair, I saw somebody catch that. And I wanted to be like, he's working very hard.
Leave him alone.
Don't talk about my boy that
way. People did catch me fall asleep.
But nobody knew you were doing that because it was like kind of under wraps.
Yeah, it was on the DL. So like, I didn't want to blow my spot. But I fell asleep a few times and I felt shitty about it. But I was so fucking tired.
Also kind of on brand.
Oh, yeah. I fall. As somebody who knows me in real life, Chris will say I fall asleep a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Any car ride, I am out.
It's instantaneous.
Yeah.
I'm asleep.
He doesn't
boy.
Even, he just goes,
he's
I don't need
15 minutes in the studio.
Yeah.
Oh, I fall asleep in that other studio so much now.
Really? I love it.
I just take,
it's
I take
nice,
my
it's
little,
private.
I take my little cat naps.
I nap in down there sometimes. There's a bench back here.
I have slept on that bench several times.
It's a good
myself.
Bench. Because then
but
you
I'm
close the door and it's
it.
So silent.
I take
in
my
there.
Shoes off. I don't make like a, I'm not a pig about it.
Yeah.
I have nice little naps. And I always have new socks on.
I
don't want to be gross. Just, you know, take a little nap ski in the studio. Now that we have the other area where I can sleep, this is much better.
Oh, I can't wait till there's recliners in that fucking studio. See, oh, God, I'm going to be taking a lot of naps here.
I don't know who bought the couch just right out there, but it is very sleepable. Natalie, you never answered.
I think my take one for the team moment was when I licked the pussy cake on my birthday.
Yeah, that was fun.
Also,
that
was also just doing the show.
Yeah, I mean, that I do every day. That was a moment where I was like, is this going to be on film? Yeah.
And it was on the podcast all right. and Gas Journal.
It was on Gas Journal. So now it lives in perpetuity on YouTube and not just behind a paywall at Gas Digital. I was like, I could be a fucking stick in the mud or I could not.
If it makes you feel any better, the one clip I've ever asked to be taken off of line.
Yeah.
Years ago, I did a show that I was hosting and it was like half comedy, half sideshow. And my friend Arlo, who Chris has met. Is me, but like if you dropped an anvil.
Yeah.
So about a foot shorter and a little bit wider.
Yeah.
And he has these giant balls. And he's got this big ball sack. And we're doing a show, and I got a little drunk because I asked for Jaeger because the bar didn't have Jaeger. And somebody went to their car and filled a pint glass with it, handed it to me on stage, and I thought it was a Guinness. And I chugged it, went, uh-oh. Was that Jägermeister?
Yeah.
And then woke up the next day.
Holy shit.
And I saw a clip, and unfortunately, Mr. Amico, Papa Paul Amico, called me. I did staple gun, where we stapled Arlo's balls to my face. And somebody put it on Facebook that night and tagged me. And I had to get a call in the most hungover I've ever been, throwing up. And my dad, and I had no idea, my dad goes, is there a video on Facebook of a guy stapling his balls to your face? I mean, he goes, buddy, you got to slow it down. He is like, listen, I don't call about stuff, but that one's real rough look.
It's also the platform. Why would you put that on Facebook? Of all
it was insane.
That's a Snapchat thing.
It was insanity.
No answer on Snapchat.
Yeah.
No.
That's only for LinkedIn.
It was that was a tough look. So don't worry, we all have our days.
Yeah, there. Are, I was gonna. I mean, I don't know. It's a weird line where I'm like, my family's very supportive of me. And they're like, you're in media. That's great. And I was going to send them our last episode. And then I'm like, oh, no, I talk about the porn I watch for half of it. Like, I can't send my dad that. Anyway, so yeah. I cut very distinct clips and send them to my parents on text message.
They asked to see them, though?
They're nice. Like,
my parents do too, and I'm like, no, I literally just, that's what you have to do. You just have to be assertive. Just say, no, you're not going to see this.
There's part of me that does want them to see me succeeding, you know?
I'm just gonna throw this out. I don't care. I hope they think I'm not.
So when me and Zac were in Rochester
doing
a show together, I just posted on Facebook, I go, if anybody's in Rochester, come to this show. My aunt texts me, I'm in Rochester, and I go, do you want to come to this show? And this is one of my only living relatives that I talk to.
Yeah.
And she went, no. I looked, do you want to come? She was like, no.
But I am in Rochester.
Yeah, but I happen to be in Rochester. If you want to come hang out with me. I was like, no.
Yeah, but how much fun was eating garbage plates and watching Andy Malafarina snore with his hand down his pants?
I mean, that's pretty much what it is to hang out with my aunt. I'll be
Over Christmas, there was family. They'd be like, how's your job going? And I'd be like, I have a show now. And they're like, that's great. Send it to me. And I'm like, you can watch this one episode. Please don't click any of the suggested links.
Yeah, I just told my family when I went to Skankfest. I'm like, I went to Vegas and we did some shows. That's it. We did some comedy stuff.
By the way, that's the obvious you're taking one for the team moment of the year was getting your dick sucked on stage.
No one said it, Zac.
So I had to say it.
You did a great job.
Greatest accomplishment of the year, what would you say it is? Mine is up there. This show is up there, if I'm being honest. It's been fun doing that.
Actually,
show.
One of my favorite moments, actually, truly, and I mean this, was being on Spook Show.
Yeah, that's a good one. And that was like silly. A last-minute fill-in.
And a funny thing to do.
The combination of them was great.
Well, you guys have great bookings. One of my other favorite bookings was having Cass and Jacob Williams on at the same time. That was pretty great.
That was very fun.
Yeah.
Personally, I'm going to go with two things. One is just, I feel like in the last year or two, I've had the privilege of now I am kind of one of the guys here that can fill in for anybody. So those days where I am doing five or six shows in a row, those marathon days I love.
Yeah.
I feel very appreciated and valuable, and I feel like I can kind of slip into different people's shows and get the vibe.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
My other thing, I'm going to go with the live by guys from Skankfest with the Dad Meat guys was one of the us busting Ian's balls about being a volunteer firefighter.
I did not know Ian was a volunteer firefighter.
Dude, that's
gayer than all the dicks he sucks.
We do that for an hour where we shit on Ian, and he took it so good and he played it right. And it's one of the funniest fucking things we've
ever
done.
And they
pretended
he needed a cane for the rest of Skankfest.
No, that was the year before. Us attacking Ian about being a fucking volunteer firefighter. At one point we said, it was like police academy, and we were doing the bit where the chief was like, finance! And I said, sorry, I'm late, chief. I slipped in Dalmatian shit. It's the funniest, the hardest I've ever fucking broke myself is the idea of Ian at a fire station sliding through Dalmatian shit going
with too big of a firefighter uniform on.
No, Rady said with a giant bucket that had been full of water but now it only has one drop, so he goes to throw it at the fire and there's nothing left. Nothing has made me laugh more. That live by guys at fucking Skankfest.
I'm so sad I wasn't there.
And then also all the money I raised for
that was great.
The Trevor Project, I auctioned off my rat trap.
Very cool.
And somebody donated, I'm sorry, my burp smelled so bad. I auctioned off my rat trap and we raised $450 for Trevor Project. That was really cool.
I want to know what that guy is doing with that rat trap now.
He bought it for his trans significant other, who's
That's
a big
awesome.
Fan.
Very cool.
So that was really cool. That was nice to see that. Nice.
Is she snapping it in her piece?
I have no idea what they're doing
with
it.
That's how they got the. That's how
God bless.
She's now post-op, thanks to you, Zac.
Yeah,
and the Trevor Project.
Made it easier. Was really cool.
Can I change my answer real quick?
Yes,
because
please.
Of Skankfest, being Eskimo Brothers with Calm Turtle is my biggest accomplishment.
They put their dick in the poster together.
Oh, yeah.
Wasn't that two Skankfests ago?
Nope.
If it was, he did it again this year.
It was Dad Meat.
Good for
Calm.
You.
Yeah, sorry, Chris gone.
My thing was when Colm and Mike became Eskimo Brothers in the poster.
All right, so my other favorite moment was Big Chicken. Oh, you remember Big Chicken?
You know about
dude?
The Big Chicken suck-off contest? So I found this flyer on, it was just, Stanley happened to be in Detroit for a wedding, and I found a flyer online for an event called
Oh, wait, yeah, I know
Big
this.
Big Chicken presents a cucumber suck-off contest, how far can you go? And I'm like, dude, you gotta go to this. And then he didn't, and I just made fun of him for 25 minutes for not going. How do you not? My girlfriend actually got mad at me because I was like, how do you not go to the suck off contest? She goes, you know, I'm like your girlfriend. You should probably. I was like, you think I'm be turned on by this cucumber suck off contest? This is freak show shit.
Yeah.
My dad once called me at 3 a.m. He goes, hey, buddy. I'm like, hey, what's up? He's like, I'm out on the road on a job. And I didn't know the hotel they booked me at also was having an event called the Jammy Jam, and it was, he goes, I'm in the hotel across the street is a Denny's, and it was a BBW all black party, so it was all black dudes in silk pajamas and all black over 300 pound women,
nice,
in teddies, but there was a Denny's,
and then teddies across, were in them,
there was a Wendy's and a Denny's across the street, and they all lined up on foot in the drive-thru.
Yeah, they somehow got the drive-thru to fucking the sensors.
And he was sending me pictures of all these black things lined up in the drive-thru ordering Wendy's without cars. He said at a certain point they like were mad, and then they're like, yeah, I guess just come through.
Yeah.
For a Waffle House type situation.
Yeah,
or
yeah, exactly. Outside of a Wendy's.
That made me think of it. Is there a video that you've been shown on a show this year that, like, just stuck out the most as the most shocking or, like, the most...
Just the I show, Chris.
There's true. Been a couple on Real Ass Podcast that have got you.
There were a couple on Real Ass Podcast.
Oh, I mean, that we
I'm
watched that
of.
Video. I had seen it, but tell me what, but the guy getting stabbed in the neck in Australia was...
Yeah,
yeah
was
and
wild.
It, like, goes like this.
And it just... And he just drops.
Yeah.
That was a fucked up video.
I mean, my favorite video of the year is that fucking scream... Falling on the Asian
yes.
guy.
Yes,
that's
that was some Looney
Tunes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That guy's dead now.
Yeah, is he?
He has
I don't
to be,
know.
Right,
I
he didn't survive
I
that.
He was
did
paralyzed.
I will. Can I say
he
I was?
He survived that.
I was just in Ireland with my dad, and we were standing on the cliffs of Moher, and there were people taking selfies over the hill where it says "Don't climb this; it's super dangerous." And they were up there taking selfies, and my dad was like, "How many people do you think die via selfie?" And I'm like, "That sounds like the show I do three times a week." And he goes, what do you mean? And I go, we have this game called Live or Die where it
does
shows
it
you, does it live or does it die? And you see a video and he was like, oh my God, that's horrible. And I go, oh, is it?
Yeah.
I forgot. I guess
I
that's
bet
pretty
there's so
fucked
many.
Up.
Can I give you the two that,
that
oh, wait, what was the
up?
The inverted babies with the red eyes?
Oh, the Harlequin babies.
Harlequin babies. We watched that. That was this year, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Spooky.
That was a me thing.
Yeah, yeah, you worked here. Yep. Yeah, you pulled that up.
The video of the guy where he touches the fan and he like cooks from the inside because he gets electrocuted.
Oh,
I have not stopped thinking about that.
Can I give you my two?
Yeah.
That one is pretty spooky, by the way.
Nightmare.
The one
don't
that got
me.
Me was where the person fell off the Ferris wheel and the slap when they hit the ground. That still haunts me.
Is that
me.
The one of the kid? The huge kid?
Yeah, I don't
yeah.
know. But, oh,
yeah,
no, it was
the big black kid.
Yeah, horrible.
And then the other one was when they were in the boat and there was that big wave that got them. Do you remember that one?
Oh, no, the cliff fell.
The cliff fell. That's what it was. Yeah,
yeah, that one, yeah.
And, I'm
then,
like, five
and then also
died.
The video of that incel that used to fuck Britney Spears breaking into her wedding was also pretty...
Yeah, I remember that.
That was a good creepy one.
This wasn't a video, but the woman who like...
Jessica Alexander, what's up? Yeah.
The girl who was stuck to her couch for 12 years in her own
what?
Shit.
Oh,
was, like,
you talked about
gal.
That on Skanks.
She's a big gal.
She was like special needs, couldn't, and then they like, there's only a photo of the couch, and she died. It was horrible.
She was more couch than person.
She was, yeah, she and the couch had become one. It was crazy.
Not the big comfy couch turning into a fat lady.
Solid.
I just taught him what the big comfy couch
scary.
Was last week.
Scary. Frightening. My new biggest fear.
He didn't like the clock dance at all.
I didn't like the clock dance.
That is my sexual awakening.
It scares me.
That show is a big part of my childhood. Not for that reason. But
I've never seen that. I know the show, but I've never
my sexual awakening.
I'm a little old for that.
Yeah, you know, that's my big crush.
Natalie, do you have any other questions?
I was going to ask about how Lewis talked about his son for three episodes last week and how he thinks his son doesn't believe in Santa when I mean, thinks his son believes in Santa. I don't think he does. I think he's like...
He's playing along because he's afraid he's going to get less gifts.
I agree.
That's also fair.
I think he's afraid of disappointing his parents. He's a really sweet kid. B, he's afraid that the Santa gifts will stop coming. And if the Santa gifts are the good ones, he's probably playing up, A, because he's in front of his little cousin.
Yeah.
B, because Lou's there, and he's doing it because he's afraid, like, because if Lewis and B get him some shit, but then Santa's the one who brings the iPad, I think in his head, he's like, I gotta keep this fucking shit moving.
And I agree.
I think there's also a C aspect of it, where it's like, there is probably some part of him that does not think Lewis lies to him.
Yeah, I agree.
You know what I mean? Like, Lewis is, like, such a good dad, and, like, B's great mom. Like, it's like, they're such good people that I think there's probably some part of his little brain that doesn't want to believe
been
lying to them for his entire life.
I was, like, I think 11 when my parents outright told me Santa's not real, and I had known that for probably since I was 9 or 10.
Yeah.
And I was like, most of the fun is suspending that he might still be real, right? Like, I knew he wasn't, but I was like, if I just outright tell him, there's a part of it that's lost now, you know? I feel like he might be doing
that. Still cheer for pro wrestlers.
Yeah.
What was the moment that made you, figure it out?
I found a letter, like, that I had written upstairs in the bathroom, right? Like, I had written a note to Santa, and then I found it somewhere else in the house.
What I did was I killed a small child, and then I realized I still got gifts. So Santa couldn't have possibly seen me do that.
Wow.
Yeah. The kid's still in that too.
Or he was just down. Yeah. he was down. And Santa was supporting you.
Like first or second grade, one of my friends told me he found his gifts in the closet, and then they were written.
And they were Zach.
Yeah, they were they were labeled from Santa. He's like, dude, I got the Santa thing figured out. That's our parents.
Wow.
I had a friend who was really religious who was never told about Santa, and she just like did not mind ruining it for all of us. She was like, he's not real. And I'm like, no, he really is. And she's like, no, he's not. My parents have literally never
said that. Let me tell you about Jesus.
Yeah, literally, she didn't come in on Halloween at school. She took the day off.
You're telling me there was a Jew.
No.
And he knew magic.
If you
and didn't try to start a stage show.
If you get Christian enough, you stop believing in holidays.
You met a Jew with 12 friends.
Yeah. Like, I had...
And only one of them turned him in for silver.
Like, I had Christian friends who just stopped believing in holidays. Like, there's a certain point you get in Christianity where you just kind of, you know, it's not even about that.
I think that's
anymore.
All religions. Mm.
No, you know what I mean. All right, well, I was just trying to, you know, get to the point where it's like, you know, it's not always the Jews. But for me, it was I found a toy that said made in China on it. I'm like, yo, is Santa outsourcing? The fuck?
That's funny. Mm.
Did you ever ask Santa for eyeballs?
I should have. I never thought of that.
You should have sold up. Yeah.
Damn.
Then he would have found out real early that he's not real.
Yeah.
Get 2 elf eyeballs. They could have donated them. Because 2 elves could wear eye patches.
Yeah. That'd be adorable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pirate elves?
Kind of I did. I mean, a cadaver is kind of like an elf, right?
Well, you have fucking dead eyes?
I have stem cells from a cadaver.
Oh. Those are his real eyes because they don't have iruses.
Oh.
But I have stem cells from a cadaver.
Just soulless black holes.
Yeah.
There was just a moment last year where Lewis was like, oh, this song was playing and it says that Santa was my dad.
Yeah.
And he know like they had a moment. And I'm like, he has not stopped thinking about that.
I mean.
No, he probably forgot about now. That is funny that Lewis is now
talking... Speaking of soulless black holes, who was on SDR a few weeks ago?
Brandon McKinnish. Very hot.
Last week, we had the magician on, and Chris, I wanted to hear, now that we're not on the SDR show, what do you think about the magician?
He was a creep.
He was a creep, yes.
Yeah, he was on the SDR show. Of course he was.
I was also on the SDR show.
That's different.
That guy was
You're
weird.
Not there just... I mean, maybe you are. I don't mean to speak for you. Just for the porn stars. This is what I was going to say.
The porn stars were cooler than the magician.
I gave her that for the magic.
Yeah, exactly. He's there just for the...
No, I was there because I want to see some card tricks.
Card tricks. Yeah, tell me about it. Tell me about that episode.
I got my dick felt. But yeah, he also fucking...
He did get his dick felt.
Yeah, he did.
All right, but that guy was weird. Were there any tricks you actually were impressed by?
They were all impressive. Magic tricks are impressive.
The card is still over there on the table. The card that he ripped, yeah.
What do you think about
I did rewatch that and realize that he ripped two different cards. I just forced a card on somebody. Like,
sure.
And he knows how to rip the card the exact same way because he's done it 500 times.
Sure.
Yeah. Can you do any magic tricks?
I can make this be or disappear.
Yo. Man. Well, all right. So I also, I mean, you don't have any magic tricks, do you?
No.
Done with this.
Okay.
Yeah, last
okay.
closing words.
All right, what did you learn from this year? I do want to know what you learned
to
this
not
year.
Do this again.
Two weeks in a row with this
to go home after High Society.
Yeah.
Damn it.
No, I'm kidding. I'm just fucking with you, buddy.
You didn't learn anything this year, Zach?
I don't want to hurt your feelings.
Yeah, but you didn't learn anything?
I'm sure I did.
They just made of rubber.
Yeah. I learned I got to pace myself. I've been drinking since 11 o'clock this morning.
It'd be the first pacing he's ever done.
Yeah.
Nothing for you, Nat?
I've learned to that, but more broadly. Like, I need to space my time
then
correctly.
Then she learned it with bronze.
Oh! Yeah. Take care of my mental health, etc.
Damn. All right. We're gonna fuck you up this year.
What did you learn? Mike?
We're going to MK Ultra her ass.
What did you learn? Everyone wants to know.
What loose pussy feels like.
I learned content management.
Sure.
And how to organize better. And I'm going to keep learning.
I feel like Mike's ball bags blew around above the pussy. Like when you know you're blowing a tube. Just your lungs.
This has been GaS Digital. Now remember to subscribe to the GaS Digital Network. Use promo code BEST to get a 7-day free trial to see all the uncensored ad-free shows that we mentioned today. Remember to follow me, That Blind Mike, on Instagram and GaS Digital, at GaS Digital on Instagram and Twitter. And subscribe to the YouTube where you can find the best of the week and GaS Digital now. Natalie, anything to plug?
Let them go first.
You guys, anything to plug?
Zach, as soon as we're done.
Let's go.
Yeah, Natalie DiChico edits on Instagram.
And Doped Up and Dying, you did the clips
for
that.
Doped Up Comedy on Instagram. Bye, everyone.
Wait. Can I plug your guys? If you're not going to plug anything, Zac Amico Midnight Spook Show, at ZA Spook Show on Twitter, at Zach is Not Funny on Instagram.
Did you get that we have to go have gay sex?
At Chris from Brooklyn on Instagram and Twitter. Check out High Society Radio. Thank you, guys.
Bye, everyone. Happy New Year. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out, new wrist, watch out, little bitch, that's a knockout. Hop in, walk out, pipe up, clock out, new wrist, watch out. Little bitch, that's a knockout.